have been drying for a couple weeks now. I think they're ready to be handled. I particularly like the dark ones, especially number two, the second one I did. I'll show you some of the metallic sheen that it has. As you can see, it's a beautiful, rich jewel tone colors. And they change according to the direction of the light. This was the first one. The lighter ones turned out very nicely as well. This was the last one, the small one. So, right now they're still on the silicone pads, and I'll show you the true paint skins. It peels off very easily. So this is the silicone pad that I had on the canvas. I used the canvas just to make it easier to tilt. But here's the true paint skin. And what I plan to do, and you can stay tuned for a future video, is I have these cuffs, DIY cuff bracelets in various sizes and colors. I have the real wide ones. And I think the gold with the jewel tone colors will look very nice, or the brass color. So I plan to attach them to the cuff. I did try, in the past, I tried cutting a canvas, but it was just too thick because you have to tuck it into the end here. So hopefully the paint skin will work nicely. And I think with the blues and whites, the silver tone looks very nice with that combination. Then I also have bookmarks that I could make. These are just plastic sleeves to insert paint skins. So that's another project down the road. And I also have these. I did them a few years ago. They're on they're on photo paper. And I stored them in glassine paper. That's the best way I found to store paint skins, in glassine paper, because I find wax paper sticks because of the humidity in Florida, where the wax can melt. And I even found parchment paper would stick. So glassine paper is the best. But I think these would make nice cuffs or bookmarks. Just have an assortment here. In this video, I'll show you how to make paint skins. As you can see, I'm using a used canvas, and I put a piece of silicone, a sheet of silicone over it. And this way, I can paint as if I'm just painting on a canvas. I'm using the bloom technique, and I'll put the recipe in the description box below, as well as all the colors. I won't bore you with all the colors now, but you can read it below if you'd like. And I'll just let you watch and enjoy. Thank you. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and stay tuned, as I mentioned, for the cuff bracelets. Well, that's it for today. Enjoy the day. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe below.